What's nice about this is that we have some articles that describe the evidence for diagnosis and management of these children. And this is going to be valuable to audiologists because there is kind of this open-ended question of how do we manage these children in terms of hearing aid technology and what type of interventions they're getting. But at the same time, I think there's information that's really important for speech pathologists about specific areas that children with mild and unilateral hearing loss are more resilient in terms of their language skills, but also they're more at risk. And so that gets at how SLPs are assessing these kids. And then that carries over to teachers because there's gonna be specific areas that these kids are gonna have trouble with, and that can affect their reading skills and just general classroom management. So one of the things that we've highlighted in this forum is that there are more significant deficits in certain areas of language. They have specific deficits in the area of morphosyntax. So they have difficulty with acquiring the English grammar system, particularly high frequency, high pitched, low intensity sounds. So this would be sounds like morphological markers like plural S, so like cats, third person singular, he walks to the store, so that S there, possessives. So any of these high frequency sounds, because those are so soft and they're on the high end of the speech spectrum, it's harder for children with mild hearing loss to access those sounds. So even though we say mild, it doesn't mean that there's a mild problem there. Another area in some of the articles that where we've seen that these children are having more difficulty is with listening comprehension. So one of the articles by Amanda Griffin shows that children with unilateral hearing loss are having difficulty with listening comprehension and noise. So they may do okay if you're just asking them to repeat backwards, but when you ask them to, if they actually understand what was said, they show deficits there. One of the things I'd like to start discussing more is talking about this hearing loss as an educationally significant hearing loss, or describing it in terms of audibility. So two of the articles in the forum talk about this idea of getting away from these terms like mild and minimal hearing loss and talking about how much access someone has to the speech spectrum. And we can actually measure this as a percentage, and it's called the Speech Intelligibility Index. But I feel like the articles really complement one another. And so we have some nice review-based articles. We have some clinical practice articles, and then we have some research articles. And it's a nice balance of articles on children with mild hearing loss, children with unilateral hearing loss, things that should appeal to speech pathologists and to audiologists. So we really tried to work towards that balance, and I think we achieved that.